First off, sorry about the strange alien noise in the background. I'm not quite sure what it is, but I can't get rid of it. I'll try to figure it out later, but I spent a little while and couldn't do it. And, also, I left my other files on another computer, so I had to follow my own tutorial to make the bathroom again. However, I didn't make the textures or the bathtub, just because the bathtub wasn't quite up to par with what I wanted, so I'm going to redo that. And the textures, I found just a few better ways to do it, pretty much. So you can either use the old ones we'd started and just tweak them, or you can do the new ones, which I'm redoing now. Alright. Let's start by creating the doors. So, create a box using AutoGrid, just on this. And give it some height. The length should be 80. The width should be 24. And the height should be 1.4. Alright. Next you're going to do is just copy this door out. Make it a copy. And just increase the height quite a bit. And actually, let's... Yeah, that should be fine. Alright, so what you're going to do next is select this, press F4 to turn the wire on, and convert it to an editable poly. Then you're going to want to select these edges, and the edges on the other side, and connect. And connect them, let's see here. Let's go with 6 tiles. Should give us a bit. So, create a box. And hopefully using AutoGrid, there we go. Make the length 4.5. And just bring it up to the top. Alright, next select this vertex right here. And line them up. So put them on the wrong side. Alright. Let's change the color of this piece. There we go. Oh, okay. Delete that. Now I'm going to left-hand viewport. Select these and bring them up. Next we're going to need 8.5 inches. So select this piece, bring it down. 8.5. Line it up. Select the vertex and drag them up. Alright, next we're going to need a 3.75 gap, so select the box, bring it down, 3.75, and line it up, select, vertex, and move it up. Alright, the next gap is going to be... Alright. Line it up. Select these. And bring it up. Then we're going to have another 6.75 gap. 6.75. And put it right here. Up. And we're going to have another 24 inch gap. What this is going to do is eventually make the designs in the door. Right. And then line these up. Z length to 4 and rotate it 90 degrees. And line it up there. Next, select all these lines. Connect and slide it until it's actually two segments, and then pinch it until it's the same. Alright? Last, we need this to be 6 inches. Okay, shift it over. And repeat the same process. So select all these lines. Connect. And give it a pinch. Here. And let's just go into perspective and bring this mesh out of it. Next, what we're going to do is select all the polygons that we're actually going to need. They happen to be these ones. Alright, and here's a picture of what we're going for. You can see this is the whole door, and this is just a part of it right here. We're pretty much going to bevel it in a little bit. You know, we'll give it a couple curves, we'll do a large bevel out, and a slightly smaller one to finish it off. So, let's attempt to do that. So, get your bevel command, and let's just start going in. Actually, it might be easier just to use this. So, that is very strange. Oh, okay. So what's happening was they were intersecting with each other. Set it a bit. Okay, bevel it outward. And let's actually go into the front view here. So we want to bevel it until it's more or less even. Okay. Back into perspective. And scale all of these down. Next, what we want to do is control-click the edges, and give them a chamfer, and we have quite a nice door now, with all the designs and whatnot. Let's go back to our picture for a second, so we can see, and yes, so, what we're going to need to do now is go on the left-hand viewport, and select all these verts and just scale up until they look even with the sides. Because even though we used a uniform scale, the tool distorts it a bit. Alright, and there is our final product for the door.